Hello, I am Cal and welcome. In this one we're going to take a step back and have a look at the PlayStation Mini and this very cheap USB port with a Gamebox USB stick attached. And as you can see, it is attached to my system here and it is still working. Even though I get quite a lot of comments in the video that I made about 12 months ago saying you're getting so many problems with this USB stick. I think a lot of it might be user error, that's why I'm making this video, and I think a lot of it may be because this is 12 months old and very very popular. The product itself has been mass produced that much and the quality of it has gone down that much that a lot of people are using this and then they're just going kaput. Or it could be user error, not 100% sure. As I say, I think there's a lot of these knocking about and the quality has gone down. I always suggest from now on, buy a USB stick, have a look at the AutoBleem software yourself and see whether you can put a USB stick together yourself rather than spending money and being disappointed. But I'll have to reiterate, this is not my product, I only did a review for it. So if you have got problems with a USB stick, speak to whoever you bought it from, not me. I can't refund you for something that's got nothing to do with me. It was just a review that I did. But I'm still getting questions, and there's a question that popped up from a Mr. Page. So this video is for you, sir. Ask very politely. Not a lot of people do ask questions politely. I don't know why. What kind of positive response are you going to get if you don't ask politely? Well, in this case, I'm going to do a response video just for you, Mr. Page, alright? But don't ask me any more bloody questions about this USB stick, alright, mate? What I am going to do in the future is I've bought a USB stick. Don't buy this one. I don't know whether it works very well with it yet. I haven't tried it yet. But I'm thinking about doing a video just for the PlayStation games, not all the rest of it. And that's what you have to understand. This software itself, there's two sides to it. You've got AutoBleem, so at the very bottom you've got a menu system, look. Okay, you've got all the options there. If you can't read that, I can't help you. You've got AutoBleem, start. Press that one, and it takes you into the menu with all of the PlayStation 1 games that are there. Alright, so you just select which one you want, and then when you're happy with the one that you want, you just press X, and then it'll boot into that game. Hello, it is me. And then, you know, it'll load up. And then you can play as a PlayStation 1 game. It takes a little while because there's a lot of software on this USB stick. So this is not set up, the Mini itself. This is an exploit that's been obviously triggered for us to access and add more games. Okay, so that's loaded up. Just pressing start on there to start the game. I haven't played this one before, but as you can see, it is working. Press the start button if I want. To come out of this, you press select and triangle. That takes you to another little menu lock, up and down. And then if you want to exit, press X on there. And that'll take you back to the main menu that we got to. This is the carousel for like save states and things. Press circle on there and then circle again, takes you back to the main menu. So to access all of the other games that you've got, all the other different systems, we need RetroArch. So you press square for RetroArch.
Hello again.
And that brings up the RetroArch menu. So if you hit left, you can see my cursor thing is there on the left hand side going up and down. If we go all the way down, we've got all the different game systems that you can see. My games are still there. God knows what you're doing with yours. I really don't know. If you've lost your games, maybe it's the scan option from the previous menu. Not 100% sure, because this is not my product. I have just done a review video for it. Can't reiterate that any further than what I can. So, the question that Mr. Page had was WWF WrestleFest. Can you try it? I couldn't access the game. Right, okay, so that is on... It's got to be main.
So we press X on there, that brings up all the games for main. W is going to be at the bottom, so if I go up from here, it'll take you to the very bottom, and then we'll have a look. WWF WrestleFest. Right, take note, look on the right hand side, it says Core Auto Detect. This doesn't always work. So these games ROMs work with emulation, different versions of different software. It's different emulators run different ROMs better or worse or not at all. So we have to select which version of the emulator to run this best. You can try the auto detect, press X and then run. But if it doesn't run that well, sometimes you just get an error message because it's selected the wrong core, which is the software running all these games. So select this, reset core association, you get a little message at the very bottom saying it's been reset. If you do that, whatever core it's been set up for has now been deleted. So you can then, when you select run, select which one you do want to use. And this is all the different arcade, different bits of emulation software that can run all the different systems. So you've got Arcade 2010, it's quite modern. You've got an even moderner version there, 2014. This is an old game, so probably the best way to run that might be with MAME 2003. It could be MAME 2000. Trial and error. So what we'll do is run with 2003, because I'm pretty sure it'll run on that. So we'll press X on there, and then X again to run it.
Hello.
And then it'll take a little while to boot up, because there's a lot of software. See, there we go. It's up and running. This is an arcade machine. That's what the simulation is. That's what the software is doing. So we need to put credits in like the old arcades. Press select. And then you can see that it's putting credits in, or just about, in the bottom right hand corner. The framework is called a bezel. God knows what it's showing Sega CD, but it should say some version of MAME. What we'll do, we'll just turn up the volume. And you can see that everything is running there. Now we've put the credits in, we can press start for a game. And there we go. Which one do we want? Royal Rumble or Saturday Night Main Event? Saturday Night Main Event. Who do we want to be? Can we be the Ultimate Warrior? We can. It's a tag team match, so we need somebody. Here we go. Jake the Snake. There we go. Introduction. Okay, you can see that it's running. We don't need to introduce who they are. You know who they are. There we go. Just come out of this. Press select and then start, and that takes us to the menu for RetroArch within the MAME thing, and this is where we can do certain things, i.e. carry on, restart, or do save or load states. What we want to do is close the content, so I'm just going to press X on here to close the content, and that should take us then back to the previous menu. So on here, the bottom right hand side, you've got the different options there, but I think back is circle, not okay. So we're just going to press circle, and that takes us back to the list. And then if you want to go back to the main menu completely, so we can choose between PlayStation or back to here, we can go back to the main menu by pressing circle. It takes us back to the very top, or you can use your up and downs. And then what we need to do is close this RetroArch. So if we go across from here, we can then quit RetroArch with an X. And that'll take us back to the very main menu where we start again. And if you want to shut this down, L2 and R2, you press them together, it'll shut it down. A lot of people, if you don't shut these systems down properly, you create problems for yourself. It needs a proper safe shutdown. So that's another suggestion. Right. I hope this has answered your question, Mr. Page. Don't ask me any more bloody questions about this USB stick. I'm only joking. But seriously, I'd love to answer all your questions, but without having your USB stick in front of me, I can't really answer a lot. could be user error, or it could be an issue with your USB stick. I won't know until I actually physically see it myself. But as I say, I'm going to make a little video. Don't buy this one because I haven't tried it. And I'm going to think about making one just to add Sony PlayStation games to this USB classic. Let's just turn this down before I get tagged with something else. Right. Kyle, if you're watching this video and you want me to point people in your direction, I gladly will. Put a comment in the comment section, and then I just need to ask your permission, basically. So if you put a comment in there, then I'll put a link for your channel, because you do amazing things with these little minis. It's the PS1 and also the Mega Drive version as well, or Genesis, whatever one you want to call it. You do amazing things, mate. So this is a little clap and a salute to you, sir. Yeah, put a comment in the comment section and then I'll do a link to your channel, buddy. Let's say I just need to ask your permission first before I do that. Right, my name is Cal. Have a good morning, afternoon or good evening. Farewell till later. I hope you've enjoyed this. Please like and comment and give me some inspiration to make some more videos for you, if that's what you want. Bye for now. Experience and make your own. That's my suggestion. Then you'll understand it a little bit more.